monster! Fool, get out of my yard!
What was that?
Oh, nothing. It's a glorious day, isn't it? Day like this makes me love my job, and it's not just selling houses. Walls, a roof, a patch of sod. No, it's much more than that. It's helping people attain the American dream.
You seem to be doing pretty good at it.
How's that?
It's a nice car.
Ah, thanks.
That watch, is it 14 karat gold?
Your husband has good taste. My company has this great incentive plan. You make $5 million your first 5 years, guaranteed.
Maybe I should get in this line of work.
If you're serious, let me know. I'll talk to my sales manager. How long you two little pumpkins been married?
3 months.
3 months? That's wonderful. I'm a family man myself. And now you're ready to find that cozy little love nest, huh? Well, I'm not going to waste any more of your time jawboning. What say we take a look-see? Huh?
Okay.
I don't believe in saving the best for last, so I'm going to start off with it. This one's nice and secluded on the end of the cul-de-sac with woods behind. Do any fishing, Alan? You like to fish?
When I can find the time.
Down the dirt road at the end of the street, there's a beautiful small lake that's chock full of bass and brim.
Wow.
So, let me tell you.
Here we are.
It's a 4+3 with pool, jacuzzi, and a gorgeous backyard. Ready to move in. It's only been on the market a couple of months.
Did the sellers move?
No. They're not living anymore.
Not living? You mean they're...
Dead, deceased, defunct, moved away to that great subdivision in the sky.
What happened?
You sure you want to hear about this? Well, I suppose you'll find out sooner or later. And as your real estate agent, it's my ethical duty to fully disclose all information about the property. It's a lurid little tale, let me tell you. But hey, these things happen, even in the suburbs. A couple lived here, Lewis and Sarah Fremont. The whole thing started one night when Lewis was going away on a business trip.
Take care, I do love you.
You should have waited.
I couldn't wait. Why don't you let me take you out of here right now?
No, it's not time. It will be, I promise, soon.
No.
have any idea what a 12-gauge shotgun will do to a man's head at point blank?
Oh, God. Louis. No. Please.
Shut up!
Put some clothes on.
Copy that. Copy it, or I'll splatter Frank's head all over the bed. It is Frank, right?
Yeah, it's Frank.
That's a little letter to Frankie here, telling him that you won't be seeing him anymore.
Right!
See, I've known about what's been going on here for quite some time. But I waited, until I could catch you with your pants down. And now that I got you where I want you, I'm gonna send you both straight to hell. Now you get to hang, you little whore. And Frankie gets to watch. Go ahead. Get up.
Louis, please.
Get up!
Put your head in. Put it through. Yeah, that's a good girl. Frankie, pull your pants up. Good boy. Go over to the desk. Go over to the desk and pick up that note.
Do it!
Then move to the door. Turn around. Good. That's it. Now, when the police find the bodies, it's gonna paint a pretty little picture. Rejected lover, won't take no for an answer. He comes back for more. He gets a little bit out of hand, and she blows him away with a shotgun. Then she's so upset by what she's done, she commits suicide. That's beautiful, isn't it?
You're insane.
Well, I'm a little upset, Frank.
I'm gonna let you watch her squirm for a little while, and then I'm gonna give you both barrels. Because I want you to see that while you're still kicking.
Take those. They'll help you sleep. That's it. But we gotta get rid of the body. All right, it's the only way. We gotta make it look like he just disappeared.
We have to call the police.
Oh, Sarah, I shot him in the back. And you're a rich widow. You think they're gonna believe us? No. I gotta sink Lewis to the bottom of the lake where no one will find him. And I gotta do it now. We gotta do it tonight. You understand me? All right? I just want you to get some sleep. All right, sweetheart? And I'll take care of everything.
In the lake. He's dead. All right, well, you just had a bad nightmare. Come here. Come here, it's all right. Lewis is gone. I'm right here. Come on, relax. Come here. It's all right. Okay.
One.
It's the police. What the hell are they doing here?
That's Clay Hendricks, one of Lewis's drinking buddies.
What the hell is he doing here so early in the morning?
I don't know. He sees me. Oh my God, what do we do?
Just go to the door.
Do you think he knows?
No, no, he doesn't know anything. He's probably just here looking for Lewis or something. I don't know. Just go get rid of him.
I'll tell him. I'll tell him Lewis is still in bed.
No, no. Tell him Lewis left on a business trip.
Morning, Sarah.
Morning, Clay.
Hey, is Lewis around?
No, he's out of town.
Oh, that's funny. We were planning on doing some fishing this morning.
He must have forgotten. He's in Sacramento with a client. But he'll be back later on this evening.
Yeah. Well, I guess I'll be running along then. Sorry to disturb you, Sarah. Oh, tell Lewis to give me a call when he gets in.
All right.
See ya.
Bye, Clay.
Did he say something?
No. I don't know. I just felt it. It's almost as if it was a dream. Like it never happened.
That's exactly what we gotta make it look like. How you feeling?
Better.
You look better. You had me worried there for a bit.
I only wish we'd both wake up and find that it really was a dream.
Listen, we're gonna get out of this. And once everything blows over, we're gonna get out of here and we're not coming back. All right?
Hello?
Good morning, Sarah. It's Clay. Louis in?
Louis?
Yeah. I wanted to hold him that fishing date. He made it in all right last night, didn't he?
No, he didn't.
Listen, Sarah.
I don't mean to alarm you, but I think there's something strange going on.
What do you mean?
Well, I ran into Louis's secretary at the bakery yesterday. She said Louis left the office at 6 on Friday and was heading straight home.
She didn't know anything about any client in Sacramento.
Well, I don't know what Cindy told you, but Louis left Friday night, like I said.
Which hotel was he staying in?
I don't know. He didn't say.
Well, I can make some calls easy enough to find out. Which car is he driving?
Which car? He was driving his car.
All right.
I don't need to get all excited yet. Like I said, he's probably fine. I'll call you in the morning, and if he's not back by then we can start worrying.
All right. Thanks, Clay.
Don't mention it.
The car. How could it be so stupid? He must have left it out on the road. That's it. There it is. We gotta get rid of it. We're lucky Hendrix didn't see it.
Maybe he did see it. Maybe he suspects us and is waiting to see if we move it.
Oh, no. But if they find a car here, we're fucked. Louis has vanished. The car's gotta vanish with him. Damn! Where are the keys?
He must have had them on him.
So then they're at the bottom of the lake. The wheel's locked. This thing ain't moving. Where do you keep the spares?
On the rack in the kitchen.
They're not here, Sarah. And where else would he keep a spare?
I don't know. I don't know.
Wait. Are you sure he even has another spare?
I don't know.
Think for a second.
I don't think he had a spare.
Jeez! One set of keys, the son of a bitch has got them on him. I'm gonna have to go get them then.
What? What do you mean?
It's getting late. I want you to search this house anywhere the keys may be, and if you can't find them.
I'll go fish him out of the lake.
I'm scared, Frank.
There's nothing to worry about. Once we move the car, they can't trace anything to us, and without a body, Hendrix can't prove anything.
It's not him I'm afraid of.
What's the matter?
I don't know. It's just these dreams I've been having. And the idea of you having to go back into the water with that corpse.
What's Louis gonna rise from the dead?
Huh? I don't know. I have a very strong feeling about this. It's like a premonition.
Right, they're dreams. Like you said, dreams. You're having nightmares. That's all they are. They're just dreams. Okay, and they're gonna pass.
Be some other way.
No, I have to do this. All right? It won't be long. I don't know, you babe.
Thank you. Morning, Captain.
Morning. What do we got here, Hendricks?
Real mess.
Morning, Captain.
From what I've been able to piece together, it looks like Sarah did away with Lewis. Or she and her lover both did.
I stumbled onto it Saturday when I came to pick Lewis up to go fishing. She was so nervous, I knew something was up.
Nutcase. When I called later to check on Lewis, she must have thought I was on to her, and that must have pushed her over the line. She offed her lover with a double-barrel shotgun, and the bitch hung herself. Still haven't found Lewis's body, but I'm sure it'll turn up somewhere. Only one thing I can't figure out. Medical examiner's looking into it. Whole body's covered with some kind of slime.
This is where it happened, right here.
My God.
Are you gonna stand there and tell us that her husband came back from the dead?
I'm not saying he did. I'm not saying he didn't. But I hear things, you know. This is a tight-knit community. And in my job, you gotta keep your finger on the pulse. Anyway, this is a great house, don't you think? I love that beam ceiling.
I don't like it.
You know, I think you could get a really good deal on this place in light of what happened.
We're not interested.
I appreciate that. Hey, no problem. No problem at all. There are plenty of other salmon in the sea. Say, would you like one of our complimentary pens?
No, thank you.
Yeah? The next one. It's okay. They're gonna love the next one.
Here we are. Stop number two.
It's beautiful.
I had a feeling you'd like it. Shall we?
There's a beautiful swimming pool and gazebo in the backyard.
Sure. $5 million. Guaranteed. How do they do that?
Sales contest. Matter of fact, my office is having one right now. This is the last day.
So how you doing?
The truth? Not so good. But if I sell you, I can turn the whole thing around. I've got till 5 o'clock. But hey, no pressure. I want you to find a house you can fall in love with.
Just what we've been looking for.
It's perfect. I can't believe it's in our price range.
I know.
You did a pretty good job patching that up.
Do you have any pets?
No.
Good.
Why do you ask?
Oh, nothing. I guess I should level with you. Hard to believe it happened here. Ron and Carol Gatley were such a happy couple. They loved each other very much, but the apple of Ron's eye was his daughter, Jennifer. He was tightly wrapped around her finger in that wonderful way that only 8-year-old daughters can do to their fathers.
Hey, Princess, come here!
He, in turn, was her whole world. Until one morning,
I don't know, sweetheart. What?
No, you gotta guess.
I don't know. What?
Come on, just guess.
All right, princess. A squirrel.
No, a monkey.
A monkey, huh?
Yeah, and he's wearing this funny little red suit.
Oh, cool dude.
He's awesome. So, can I keep him?
No. Are you sure it's a monkey?
Well, of course I'm sure.
Could be a squirrel. Sometimes a squirrel looks like
I know what a squirrel looks like, Daddy. I'm not stupid.
I know, princess. I didn't mean it that way.
It is a monkey. Besides, if it was a squirrel, he wouldn't be wearing this funny little red suit.
Well, you got me there.
So, can I keep him?
I'll tell you what. Go ask your mom.
Okay. Mom, Mom! I found a little monkey in a red suit, and I want to keep him for a pet. But I've got to hurry and get back outside and make sure it doesn't run away. So hurry and get up so you can come and see him, quick! Come on, Mom!
A monkey?
Oh, what's the rush, princess?
Come out and see Bobo.
Bobo?
That's his name, Bobo, but I've got to get outside because he wants some more.
Oh.
He just loves cereal.
I see.
Do you think she could have really found a monkey?
What would a monkey be doing in our backyard? Then again, you never know.
You scared him.
Well, I'll be. It really is a monkey.
See, I told you it was a monkey.
Well.
It's okay, Bobo. He won't hurt you. Just Daddy. Come on.
How you doing there, Bobo?
A monkey.
Yeah, with a funny little red suit.
Can I keep him?
Oh, no, sweetheart.
Why not?
Well, he must belong to someone. We'll have to see if we can find out who his owner is, huh?
But what if he doesn't have an owner? Then can we keep him?
I don't know, Princess. We'll see.
Please, Daddy, I'll feed him. I'll cook for him.
Okay, I'll tell you what. You can keep him until we find his owner.
Right? Yes, thank you, Daddy.
All right.
Did you hear that, Bobo? You're staying with me now. And if you're a good little monkey, maybe you can stay with us forever.
Princess.
Oh, that's what I like to see. Firm parental control. You know, it looks like an organ grinder's monkey you might see at a carnival or something.
Yeah.
I'm gonna check around, see what I can find out.
Well, you may not have to. We'll probably be gone by the time she gets home from school.
Okay, Mom, I'm ready.
Call me from the office, then.
Okay, well. Bye, Princess.
Mom, hurry. I can't wait to get to school. Meredith is gonna freak once I tell her I got a pet monkey.
Okay, all right, let's go. Bye. Talk to you later.
Bye. Bye. Have a good day.
Okay,
you too.
Bye, Daddy.
Bye.
Taken an attachment to that monkey. They have been playing together ever since she got home from school. It's cute. Dinner in 10 minutes.
Okay.
Hi, Princess.
Hi, Daddy.
Hi, Daddy. Don't I get a kiss? Jennifer, I need to talk to you for a minute.
No, no, Daddy.
Jennifer, I don't know if it's such a good idea to keep Bobo here in the house.
But you said I could keep him.
No, wait a minute. What I said...
Well, you said was I could keep him. I heard you.
Jennifer!
See? You're scaring him.
I didn't do anything.
Yes, you did. You're scaring him. Now get away!
Now listen here, young lady. You just lower your voice. I was only trying to tell you that I don't think it's safe to have this animal in our house.
But you already said I could keep him, okay?
What I said.
You said I could. I heard you.
Jennifer.
Max. Hey, Max.
No. No.
Max.
I want that monkey out of this house.
But you said...
I don't care what I said. I want him out.
But Daddy!
You hear me? I want him out of the house! Now!
Ron. Eat your dinner, Jennifer.
I'm not hungry.
Look, Princess, we just can't have a monkey loose in the house. He'll tear things up.
No, he won't. Max is scared, and that's all. He didn't hear anything in the house till you came home.
Well, we can't have those two animals in the same house together, that's all.
Well, you could put Max outside.
Oh, Jennifer, come on. Max has a little seniority around here, don't you think? We can't put him out in the cold just because you found a wild monkey today.
I could keep him in my room. I won't ever let him out. I'll feed him all.
Absolutely not. Princess, I'm sorry, but he can't stay in the house, and that's final.
I'm not hungry. May I be excused? I'm going to bed.
Princess, got a kiss for your dad? Anything unusual about that monkey?
What do you mean?
I don't know. Just something about it, something strange.
You just don't like anything that steals your little girl's affections from you. I don't think I ever remember seeing you that mad.
That's something else. There's something about it. It's, it sounds stupid, but I just almost feel like it's, I don't know, like it's evil.
Ron, it's just a monkey.
I just don't like it playing with Jennifer, that's all. I just don't like it safe.
Well, I saw him playing with her all afternoon. He seemed fine. He was gentle with her.
I'll go lock up. Yes, I decided to end this feud in the most rational way possible. Confinement.
I assume there's a legal precedent for your solution, counselor?
Yeah, it's called compromise. Where is she?
In her room.
Wish me luck. You've been keeping Bobo in here, and until we find his owner, you may continue to keep him in here on one condition. While he's in the house, he must stay in his new cage.
But what if he doesn't like it?
Well, then he just has to stay outside.
Well, all right.
Okay, good. All right, Bobo. Okay, let's see how Bobo likes his new cage, huh? All right, Bobo. Take it easy.
It's okay, Bobo. It won't hurt you. It's okay. It's okay.
Take it easy, all right? I'm not gonna hurt you, all right? Here we go.
You hurt him!
Monster bit me! Jennifer, I want you to find that little beast and I want it out of the house. You hear me?
And I said I wanted that monkey out of the house, I meant it.
Now you get back to bed, young lady. I don't want to hear another word from you tonight. I can see we've been having a little discipline problem around here lately. I'll talk to you in the morning.
See, look what I got.
Oh, what's the matter, boo-boo? Just your friend Max here? Oh, no. Don't worry, he's already had his dinner. Sleep tight, huh? Maybe tomorrow we'll take a little ride down to the vet, and you'll get to sleep for good.
Thank God for Saturdays, huh, Max? Of course, you're a dog. Every day's a Saturday to you. Let me just see what's going on, and we can go for... Oh! Where is he?
What?
Don't you dare give me that innocent act. Where's the damn monkey? You snuck right back down here and let him out, didn't you?
No, I didn't, Daddy.
How the hell did he get out of his cage? Where is he?
I don't know, Daddy.
Where is he? Up in your room?
No, I didn't let him out of his cage, Daddy. I don't even know where he is.
You get back to your room, young lady, right now. Do you hear me? Go! I need you to leave this house.
Ron, you're getting a little out of control.
You know what that damn thing did? I can't explain it now. Just go. Please, do as I say. Just go. There's a wild monkey loose in my house, and I need some help.
I'm sorry, sir. That's not a police matter. You'll need to contact animal control.
Okay, fine. Could you connect me? Hello? God.
I can't have anything for you till Monday. I
can't wait till Monday.
But like I told you, it's a busy day. All my trucks are out.
Then I'll drive you.
You sure are anxious to get rid of that monkey, aren't you?
I'll give you another 100 after you get him.
What's the hitch?
I told you, he's dangerous.
No problem. It's go time.
This way.
Why don't you wait out here? Give me a couple minutes to find that little fucker.
Hello?
What has gotten into you? It's okay. It's okay. I'm okay.
Okay.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
Just get inside. Just get inside.
Ron? Are you sure you're all right?
I'm fine.
Why don't you come up to bed?
You go on. I'll be up there soon.
He was killed by his own daughter?
The cops said it was self-defense. It looked like Daddy went off the deep end, killed Mommy, the dog, and the poor bastard from the pound. Jennifer spilled the beans, and it was the last thing she ever said. She's catatonic to this day, sad to say. But you have to understand, folks, any place you see around here is going to come with a little history.
What happened to the monkey?
Monkey's long gone. Nothing to worry about. So what do you say? Like to make an offer? No?
No.
You know, you won't find a better house in your price range. If you want something this nice, you're gonna have to take something with a little history. I suppose every neighborhood has a bad apple or two. These are all quality homes. We wouldn't list them if they weren't.
Look, no more haunted houses, okay?
Right.
I want to see nice, regular homes, the ones where the owners are ordinary, decent, upstanding people.
All right. No problemo. Oh, here we go.
Now, this is a really great house. If I was in the market, I'd buy it myself.
Did anyone die in it?
Did anyone? Oh, no, 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 nothing like that. Scout's honor.
This one has all the amenities. There's even a finished rec room in the basement. It's great for kids if you're thinking of having them. Also, you might want to check out... Excuse me. Sorry. Yes?
Give me an update.
I'm showing the Goodwin house right now.
Did they make an offer?
No, not yet, but it looks promising.
You're short on time.
It's not even 4:15. You said I have till 5, right?
Who is that?
My boss.
You look like you were talking to the IRS.
My numbers are down. He's putting pressure on me to perform.
So if your sales are off, you make a little less commission. So what?
It's not just lost commission. There are consequences for poor performance.
Consequences?
I shouldn't be talking about this.
Why not?
Because I signed a confidentiality agreement. But hey, I shouldn't be complaining. Like I said before, the incentive plan is amazing. So, oh, do you like it? I think it's perfect for kids. Which reminds me, have I shown you my family?
Why did the owners move?
What?
Why did the owners move?
They had a problem. Kind of a unique problem, really. I never heard of anything like it. It's really peculiar, actually. I probably shouldn't have opened my mouth, but hell, I've got to tell you.
Full disclosure.
Full disclosure. It's the law.
Right.
Right. The Goodwins lived here. Nicest, most normal couple you'd ever want to meet. I sold them this house, in fact. They lived here for 2 years, and everything was great until last fall.
Last fall?
Yeah, what happened?
Their son, Sean, went to see a psychiatrist all on his own. His parents didn't know about it. After the problems started, I guess he needed someone to talk to. The way I heard it, the shrink had just seen her last patient and was ready to pack it in for the day.
Halfway out the door.
I know. I'm sorry. He said it was urgent.
Tell him I just finished with my last patient. Make an appointment for next week.
I did. He says it can't wait. I'm sorry, Dr. Corey, but I didn't know what to do. He seems so upset. Says he won't leave until he talks to you.
All right, Gail, send him in.
Dr. Corey?
Yes.
Sorry to bother you. I know I don't have an appointment. I'm Sean. Sean Goodwin.
Helen Corey.
Thanks for seeing me.
Oh, it's all right, Sean. Have a seat. What seems to be the problem?
Have you ever heard of the Granny Killer?
Yes, of course.
What do you know about him?
I don't know. Only what I've read. A classic psychotic. A recent string of killings in the suburbs. The killer wore a rubber mask resembling an old woman.
Exactly.
What do you know about the Granny Killer, Sean?
Oh, nothing. But I knew the victims. And I watched them die. One by one. Do you believe in telepathy, Dr. Corey? A precognition?
I don't know, Sean. I've never seen any definitive data to support it. But it hasn't been disproved either.
Don't blame you. I didn't believe it myself at first. Until the vision started.
You said you began having visions, Sean. What kind of visions?
They say ignorance is bliss. That what you don't know won't hurt you. All I know is things used to be different. I'm not saying they were perfect. It was the happiest I'd been in a long time. Maybe ever. My parents are very successful, you know. Maybe they loved each other once. They got plenty of green, but so what?
Hello?
I've always been a loner. No brothers, no sisters.
Sean! It's for you!
My parents were away on business most of the time. My whole life, I've never really been close to anyone. Until Jasmine. Yeah.
Are you ready?
Hmm?
Are you still in bed?
Yeah.
Wish you were here with me.
You'll have your chance again soon.
How soon?
We're going jet skiing, remember?
Oh, yeah.
So get your ass in gear.
Yes, ma'am.
How soon can you be here?
As soon as I take a shower.
Okay, but hurry.
Amber and Zach are here already.
All right. I'm turning on the water. I'm getting naked, which reminds me of what we were talking about earlier.
It's good for you to have something to look forward to. Now take your
shower.
Better make it a cold one.
Think of me when you're lathering up.
Bye.
A good girl. Now come to Granny.
Did you talk to anyone about your vision? Your parents?
No.
Why not?
They wouldn't understand. Probably think there was something wrong with me. Send me to the doctors and shit like that. Besides, they don't like to know about problems. They're too busy with their work.
What made you think that your experience had been psychic?
I didn't. Not at first. I thought maybe I was losing my mind. Then I saw it on the news. Someone had found her body behind the video store in the alley.
And you're sure it's the same woman?
She had been stabbed 14 times. Her throat had been slit. Didn't take Stephen Hawking to figure it out.
Did you call the police?
What for? They just would have thought I was some kind of wacko.
But you said you saw the killer.
I could have told them that the killer was wearing a granny mask. They found that out soon enough. He struck again a week later. My parents were out of town. Another buying trip to Europe. Jasmine came over.
Marco.
We had the house to ourselves.
Hello.
Nights like that,
Marco.
With her.
Hello.
We're magic.
Marco.
Hello.
Marco?
Polo.
Marco. Come on, I give up.
Quitter.
You're too good for me.
Rewards come to those who persevere.
Oh?
I'm taking off my top.
Marco.
Polo.
Marco.
Polo.
Marco.
Polo.
Marco.
Polo.
Marco.
Nothing to be afraid of. It's just Granny.
Did you tell Jasmine about your visions?
After that, she wouldn't see me anymore. I apologized, tried to explain. She wouldn't even talk to me. Avoided me at school, wouldn't return my calls. I think she thought I was some kind of sick creep, pervert. Then all of a sudden, everybody knew about it. Suddenly, I didn't have any friends.
There was no one you could talk to?
The crowd we hung out with weren't my friends. They were hers.
That must have been hard on you.
She was the first person that I ever loved. The one person I could talk to. She was my world. I pushed her away. The next morning, it was in the headlines. She was a teacher at my school. This time, there was a witness, but by the time the police got there, the body was almost unrecognizable. Her body had been dismembered, scattered throughout the school. They didn't have her ID. They never would have identified her. They looked everywhere, but they never found it.
Her ID?
No. Her head. The killer must have taken it with him.
Dr. Corey, I'm going now.
I have a few more things to wrap up. Think you could stay late tonight? All right.
I'll see you tomorrow.
All right. Good night, Gail.
Good night.
Can you imagine what it was like? Knowing there was someone, a lunatic out there, knowing he would kill again? I lost my appetite, couldn't sleep. I was afraid to close my eyes, afraid of what I'd see. Images froze in my mind. Those women, their faces. I'd lay awake at night, wondering what kind of man could be behind that mask. Maybe not a man at all, but a demon. What kind of rage could make someone do something like that? My grades dropped. That's what got my parents' attention.
Are you a good student?
Most of the time, they don't even know I exist. But let the academics slide and watch out. First, they thought it was drugs. Sent me to the doctor. When I tested negative, they decided I needed drugs. Put me on antidepressants. None of it did any good. After that, I spent a lot of time away from home. Driving. Finally, I started to relax. Things were almost back to normal. And it happened again.
Kester.
The granny killer? We've already made an arrest on that one.
No, you've got the wrong man. Look, he's still out there and he's about to strike again.
Wait a second. How do you know? Have you seen him?
No, I just know.
Don't tell me. You're psychic, right?
Yes, look, that's right. Look, a girl's gonna be killed. You gotta get somebody over there while there's still time.
Why don't you come into the station? You can file a report.
No, there's no time for that. Don't you get it?
Police would never believe me. Left before they arrived. That was 2 nights ago. I haven't been home since. Could I have done it? Blacked it out? Forgotten? Maybe when I was in some kind of fugue state?
I think I can help you, Sean. I'd like to try. But it'll take time. We should call your parents.
You don't understand, Dr. Corey. I didn't come here looking for treatment. I had another vision this afternoon. The granny killer's gonna strike again. And you're the next victim. Why won't they believe me? He'll kill again and again, and there's nothing anyone can do to stop it. You don't believe me, do you?
Rights and Towers, Suite 807. For God's sakes, please hurry.
Little girl, and come to Granny.
Tough being a kid these days. But what do you think? Come on, it's a charmer, isn't it?
Is this your idea of the American dream?
I wasn't trying to mislead you. Nothing bad ever happened in this house.
I don't want to see any more houses with you. I don't like this neighborhood. I wouldn't live here if you paid me.
But lots of happy families live here.
We don't care. We're not interested.
The contest is over.
Please, just give me a few more minutes.
Your wife and son are here.
No, I have the couple right here. I think they're about ready to make an offer. Make me an offer. Please, I just need a little more time.
Put the boy on the line. All right, son, tell your daddy how much you want him to sell the people a house.
Please, daddy.
Make me an offer.
We're not making an offer.
You have to buy a house from somebody. Why not me? These are quality homes.
Forget it. We're done. Take us back to our car now.
You are not leaving without making an offer. Rates are down, but no point, no qualifying loan.
You! It's a look!